So what is going on, guys? Welcome back to yet another video here on the Freak Flyers YouTube channel. And today we're going to be doing my personal top 9 favorite skydiving videos of all time. The preface of this video is that I am going to show you guys the videos that I watched as a kid growing up at a drop zone that were either popular or I for some reason really liked them and was exposed to them at a young age, and so they influenced my skydiving and base jumping very, very much. They actually influenced my life in multiple different forms, past not just in my sports. If you watch these videos and you listen to some of the music that I use, some of the editing styles that I use, some of the type of jumping that I do, it's very influenced by a lot of this stuff. And I am proud of it because these are the things I grew up watching and that I've always loved all of my life and that inspired me to do what I do currently. They are in order of preference. It's not to say that I dislike any of these videos. No, they are the top 9 videos of all time. If I'm ever buried alive for the rest of my life with a TV playing videos and these videos are playing on the loop, I would be completely fine with it. I would be entertained for all eternity, basically. So I'm going to start with 9 and all the way up to 1, meaning that 9 is the one that, not that it had the less influence, but actually that I've watched the least amount of times. And then number 1 will be the one that I watched a lot. So all of these I've watched dozens of times, but if you go up to the ones that are number 1, I probably watched hundreds of times. And I'm not even exaggerating when I say this. Some of these videos are playing on loop as screensavers on my office, so I really am exposed to them really, really every day. So without further ado, let's get started. So in number 9, I put my old Skydive Portugal videos. These videos are from the beginning period of Skydive Portugal, right from the company, when the company was started, up until the era of digital cameras was used, up until the era where digital cameras started to be used. So this was all videos from cassette times. They are beautiful and they remind me very much of how the drop zone was when I was a kid, and also they remind me of what I had to do and how I learned to start editing videos. So that was pretty amazing. I remember I started editing videos when I was like 10 years old. That's when I learned, even a little bit less than that actually, that's when I learned to use an iPod and a mixing table and a DVD player to edit videos for tandems and everything. And then eventually when I was like 11, I started to use iMovie and now Final Cut Pro. But these videos are the essence, and I'll let you guys watch a little bit of them, of every video. Ready or not, here comes the voice for the sound. Here comes the boom. Ready or not, how you like me now, I say. Here comes the boom. Ready or not, here comes the voice for the sound. Here comes the boom. Ready or not, how you like me now. So yeah, everything old school. Don't expect to see a lot of crazy flying in some of my own Portuguese videos, simply because these are more for the nostalgia, not for the how cool the things are in the video. Number 8, I've included Jeb Corliss's a Year in the Life video.
10 seconds, and Jeb Corliss USA.
One, extremely influential video for a lot of the early base jumpers in Portugal. Everybody loved to watch it, and it was very relevant because it was when the first like generation of base jumpers existed in Portugal, was a parallel to this video. So a lot of the people that were starting at the time, actually not first generation, but actually second generation of base jumpers, they were starting and they were all super excited watching the videos and actually doing that stuff, even though Jeb was doing crazy aerials and most of the people here that were learning at the time were doing handhelds off the bridge, and I was not even old enough to remember properly, but I do remember going on the base trips when I was really, really young, and it was really, really fun to watch people jump. I don't know why they don't bring kids to base trips anymore. I wonder what changed. In number 7, we've got Olaf Zipser's videos, and I'm going to include 2 in 1 here. I have Olaf Zipser's Free Fly Palm Beach video and also Olaf Zipser's Free Fly Chronicles 1 and 2. these are amazing. These are some of the original Freak Life, Freak Lifestyle, Free Fly, the origins of Free Fly. And it's not just how Free Fly was started, it's how the whole lifestyle of being a free flyer got started. And that's why they are so amazing. They really portray how the early days of free flying were, and just brings back cool memories. Not that I was alive at that time, but the wave of free fly came much later to Portugal. And so I was, just when I was beginning to understand what the different disciplines were and that there were different things that you can do in the sky, not just fall, that's when the free fly old school lifestyle was being introduced. So you could perfectly see, even as a kid, there was two very distinct crowds. There was a free fly crowd, which were really funny, playful. Then there was the formation skydiving crowds that were much older, more serious military dudes. So of course, me as a kid, I would connect way better with the free fly crowd. So that's why I've always loved the free fly side a lot more. Number six, we've got Anti-Gravity Movie by Patrick Passé. It's an amazing movie, and it's one of the influences of some of the other movies that I love. The way that the movie is directed, it's really, really similar to some of the other skydiving films you'll see featured. It's amazing because it takes this different approach where it's not just a movie about one specific thing, it actually multiple things at the same time that are combined into different chapters and presented to you. And it's not just cool things that are being done. They actually include special parts to those cool things. So for instance, it does show amazing sky surfing and they show a sky surf tandem. It shows amazing freestyle and also shows freestyle with a plane, flying with a Pilatus, which is my biggest dream in skydiving period to do, is free fly with a Pilatus. I've always dreamed of doing that. And I will one day, hopefully. Not wingsuit, I mean free fly with a Pilatus. And so it's got it all. It's got the normal thing, let's say, which is already pretty amazing. And then it's got the little spicy version of everything. That's why I absolutely love it so much. Number five, it's a very similar movie, but it's older. It's a very similar movie to Anti-Gravity, simply because you can feel like it was directed by the same person. Patrick was responsible for it as well. But it takes a different approach. It's more of a documentary style. And because it's more recent, it already includes a little bit of things that I also love. It includes a lot of free fly. It includes now also swooping and base jumping, which is two things that I love so much. So because it's got the same spirit as the original Anti-Gravity, but more modernized things, and also with commentary, it's absolutely incredible. Love that movie a lot. And one of the ones I watched the most because it was on my computer for a long time and the other ones weren't. Number four, King of the Swoop, Emporia Bravo. There's some movies about these events. I specifically remember watching the 2006 trailer because, again, some of the guys that working in Portugal and were skydiving, they were the gods, they were the swoopers, and they came back from Emporia. We were all like, oh, we want to watch that. And there was some people that had like the DVD or cassette or whatever, and you got to watch it very rarely on the drop zone. It was absolutely amazing on the, like, an old PlayStation 2 that they had on the hangar. On the other hangar, not on our hangar. It was crazy. You got to watch these super things, and then you're like watching a video of like that's like 50 minutes long, just to watch your friend that you know from the drop zone in Portugal swooping past everyone. And you're like, oh, there you are, the canopy. Oh my god. It was cool for a kid to see someone you see every day go to a competition like that. It was amazing. Number three. Mm-hmm. This one is almost number one. It's not only number one because it only features one discipline, but it's amazing. It's the Atmanauti winner from the movie competition, skydiving movie competition back in 2001, I think. And it's basically the origin of angle flying or Atmanauti, which is like the my favorite thing in terms of flying. I cannot explain why. It's not just the type of flying, it's not about the jump, it's about the whole lifestyle, about the whole culture surrounding it. That was just amazing, and I can tell you one of the best moments I felt ever in skydiving, regardless of how many things I've done, is when I was with Marco Tiesi, which is the original Atmanauti founder. I was doing a formation with him for docks and angle flying, and I had headphones on playing the music from the video from Benny Benassi. It was one of the most incredible moments in my life. I think I've never felt so accomplished, and I was just starting my career, so there's not a lot of things that have beaten that. So that feeling so far, that pure feeling of joy, skydiving joy. Not like, oh, I'm gonna compete, I'm gonna win. No, it's just a stupid jump that's really, really simple by today's standards, yet gave me so much pleasure. And I think, and of course, it's all due to this Atmanauti lifestyle, because it was one of the things that was the most popular in Portugal. Everybody liked to track, everybody knew how to track, everybody could track together. You couldn't build a 10-way formation in head down, but you could build a 10-way formation in angle flying. So the sunset Atmanautis were all the rage, and it's when everybody got together, everybody had fun, and it was close to beer time, you know, so everybody was already excited. And I think that definitely influenced a lot what I think of flying in general, because of that damn movie, that damn film. Got no reason to go through. Baby, you know you make me blue, but I wanna get better. Number two is the Mudfly Free Fly Team videos. Mudfly Free Fly Team, it was composed of my mentor Carlos Faustino and two more teammates, and they competed in free fly, they competed in swooping. They did a lot of base jumping. The first base jumping that was done in Portugal, the first like real urban base jumping, opening objects, going to all the new crazy exit points. And these videos are like OG for me. I can tell who the people are. I know where everything is, and the things being done are crazy by the time standards. By today's standards, of course, things are much different, but I've absolutely found it to be incredible, amazing, and I just love watching. And it's not just one video, it's a whole YouTube channel, so you guys can watch. I'm gonna link everything. If there's a video, I'm gonna link down below. You can watch, man. It's so many videos, and it's everything like 2003, 2004. It's just amazing. And I was just rolling around the carpet, being kicked around, and I found it just to be incredible, incredible, incredible. And I still just get lost watching those videos hours and hours on end. Finally, the number one most influential video of my whole life, the Trace 103 from Babylon. Like a purple lac in the apple, I'm born to Mac. Steve Jobs, the beat, play God on the track. Genesis, sentences, turn these niggas to miniatures. Like I came through with senators, couple bitches and ministers. I'm just here for the game, no practice of scrimmages. Not the fame, just the images, there's some twisted appendages. Getting low on some Guinnesses while the beat never finishes. And it's, where are we going, father, farther? Away from the whack juice, close to the altar. My cult, they stay with me. Gather in a circle and shine like 650. IL, Ben's white coupe, I'm so crispy. Protected from the voodoo and Zulu mass against me. Gently brushing my shoulders through the century. Always suspicious over streets, I don't sleep. Spike wrist is Sid Vicious all over the beat. Now, there are three versions of Trace. There's Trace 101, 102, and 103. And they are all equally amazing, but the 101 and 102 the 102 was better than the 101, and then the 103 just blew everything out of the water. The level of quality, the level of art portrayed in the videos, it's just perfect. It's not available on YouTube. I think Trace 101 might be, and I'm gonna link it, but Trace 103 it's not. So if you wanna watch it, you can contact Stefan Fardell from Babylon team. Tell them Freak Flyer sent you and tell them that you want a copy of the Trace 101, 102 or 103, whatever you prefer. The 103 is the most amazing one by far. And he'll gladly probably help you get one. I know they might have a few copies left, but not a lot, because when I got mine, they were already running out. And this was quite a few years ago. It is, without doubt, the most incredible skydiving video, movie, whatever you want to call it, of all time. It features everything that's cool and everything being done to a level of incredibleness, basically, that's completely unmatched and will never be matched, in my opinion. You've got free flying, you got base jumping, you got swooping, you got events that were special, like world record attempts, you've got speed riding, everything, even Jetman, the origins of Jetman. You have everything there, and everything is done to an incredible level. It's not an old video that you watch and you're like, oh fuck, this is, I can do this. No, this is an incredible video with incredible skills and an incredible team that is also edited to perfection with incredible music. I cannot stress enough, this is my favorite video movie of all time. This is the one thing that I will never stop watching, that I must watch for the rest of my life. At least once every year I need to watch it, at least once, and it's clearly more than that. It's always playing in my office, just as a background video. It's incredible, and you guys, everybody in skydiving, if you love free flying, base jumping, swooping, etc., you should watch it, because it's absolutely amazing. And the Babylon team was definitely one of my biggest influences in skydiving, period. No questions asked. And for a good reason. So yeah, guys, this has been it. I hope this shines some light on some old school skydiving videos so that the spirit doesn't get lost along the years. Everything is much different now. Not that I'm old, but I can definitely feel that everything is different. And we are like 3 to 4 generations away from all these videos, some of them even more. But they still hold a very, very dear place in my heart. Because of how amazing they were. And so if you guys want to have a watch, I'll leave some of the links in the description down below. And I haven't been posting as much on YouTube because I've been trying to make more short form content for Instagram, and I'm sorry, I don't like it. It's not me deciding, it's just what the algorithms and what the social medias have been forcing me to do to keep up with the demand of the public. And someone's gonna do it, and someone's gonna gain from it. Might as well be me doing it to the best of my abilities. And so you guys can watch some of my reels there. They are sometimes informative. I try to cram as much information as possible into 90 seconds, which is never good, because we always have to skip stuff. But regardless, that's been it for today, guys. If you have any questions or complimentary information, you can add them in the comment section down below. And as always, I will see you guys next time.